Hello, this is Matthias Möhl for MarmorWorld.com, and in this tutorial I show you how to stabilize a shaky clip in After Effects using the MaskTracker and the extension MaskTracker Plus. After Effects already comes with a great stabilizer on board. The warp stabilizer stabilizes most clips easily with a single click. But sometimes you need more creative control. Let's take a look at this clip for example. It's a handheld shot from a boat, hence the camera is moving relative to the boat and the boat itself is moving relative to the horizon. Therefore, we can stabilize it in two different ways. Here, I stabilize the horizon. As a consequence, the horizon moves smoothly, but the boat is pretty shaky. Here is another variant where I stabilized the boat instead of the horizon. As you can see, now the boat moves smoothly and the horizon is shaking more again. In other words, the first variant feels more like the camera is flying smoothly in the air, like a drone that moves independently of the boat, whereas the second variant feels like the camera is on the boat. Let's quickly compare those two variants with a stabilization created with the warp stabilizer of After Effects. Here, with default settings, except for setting the smoothness to 100% just to exaggerate the differences. The warp stabilizer tries to stabilize the entire content of the image, so it is not able to focus on either the horizon or the boat. It tries to stabilize both the horizon and the boat, and even the woman in the foreground, which covers a significant portion of the frame. As a consequence, everything stays a bit shaky, and the result feels unnatural, because the warp tries to create the impossible, namely stabilizing everything in the frame. So in these situations, the mask tracker gives you more creative control what exactly you want to stabilize. Let's create those two stabilizations in After Effects and start with the one where we stabilize the horizon. I have already created this mask here, which includes the part of the image that we want to be as stable as possible. I included the horizon and also some clouds as they move with the horizon and offer a nice texture for the tracker. Notice that I've set the mask mode to none, such that still the entire clip is visible. We select the mask, right-click and choose Track Mask. Then we make sure the tracking method is set to position and rotation, since there is no scaling going on in this shot, and we start the track. Once the track is finished, we open MaskTracker Plus, which you find at the bottom of the window menu once it is installed. We simply select the mask and click Load, such that MaskTracker Plus extracts the tracking data from the mask. You can even select several masks simultaneously, and MaskTracker Plus will combine their movement into a single track. Now we choose the Stabilize function, make sure our footage layer is selected, and click Apply. Now we choose to smooth the movement and click OK. Now our layer is stabilized. MaskTracker Plus also created this null layer, which contains various effect controls to refine the stabilization. Let's increase the smoothness of position to 370 frames to make the movement even more smooth. Finally, we increase the scale here about 120% to get rid of the borders. And this is the result with a stabilized horizon. To stabilize the boat instead of the horizon, we would need to do exactly the same steps, except that we would track a part of the boat instead of the horizon, as I've done in this composition here. That's how easy stabilization with a mask tracker is. Track the region that you want the stabilizer to focus on, load the mask into MaskTracker Plus, and apply the stabilize function. And if you ever have issues getting an accurate track with a mask tracker, alternatively, you can use the Mocha Tracker and Mocha Import Plus with a very similar workflow. For more infos about this, please visit the tutorial section of MarmorWorld.com, where we've got plenty of tutorials about Mocha Import Plus, Mask Tracker Plus, and other After Effects techniques. Again, this is Matthias Möhl for MarmorWorld.com, and I'm looking forward to see you in the next tutorial.